the music of Charlie Johnson and his band. Charlie Johnson was born 1891 in Philadelphia and died 1959 in New York City. He was a very good pianist, but especially a good composer, band leader, and he led an ensemble in New York in the Small's Paradise, which was a famous and long time nightclub in Harlem. And he recorded between 1925 and 1935. No, he played there from 10 years, from 1925 to 1935. And he recorded only between 1925 and 1929. He was a good pianist, but he didn't play too much solos, which is a pity, because we have at the piano the man I will never forget, Andrew Oliver. The band called Charlie Johnson's Paradise 10, because of that club, had very, very good musicians. In the trumpet sections, Leonard Davis, Sidney De Paris, Thomas Morris, and of course, Jabbo Smith. Our Jabbo Smith today is my friend Jan Kaiser. Let's hope for the best. And Thomas Morris, or whatever, is my very good pal, Andy Schumm. As trombonist, the band had the most famous trombonist, starting with Charlie Irvis and later Jimmy Harrison. And this is Graham Hughes. You know, Jimmy Harrison was so good that he could use his own will to play either with Charlie Johnson or Fletcher Henderson's orchestra, both in the same city. And Fletcher Henderson gave him 1 year off to play with Charlie Johnson and said, "Your stool is always free for you to come back." Fantastic, one of the best trombonists of that time. As saxophones, another big story, alto saxophonist Benny Carter started his career there, not only as a saxophonist, but he was 19 years old, and he wrote wonderful arrangements that we are going to play. And of course, Edgar Sampson later, tenor saxophonist, another long-time musician. He played till he was 95, and Keith Nichols and I recorded with him in the late 80s, when he was about 80. that was, of course, Benny Waters. Maybe you heard him playing. He also did arranging for this wonderful orchestra. Our Benny Waters today is David Horniblow. I hope you can play till you are 95, as you are. This role model. And our Benny Carter today is, of course, Michael McQuaid. At the drums, we have Nick Ball, of course. He's especially looking forward for this hot Harlem style, right?
Joel Stafford.
And on on tuba we have Phil Rutherford. On the lovely banjo, playing wonderful playing in the orchestra. Who was it?
Bobby Johnson.
Bobby Johnson. This is not Bobby Johnson, but this is Spats Langham. And for the singing, we had the band had Monette Moore, She only sang with that band, recorded four titles. Wonderful Nicolle Rochelle. So we start off with a kind of signature tune, which is called, of course, the Paradise Wobble. Thank you very much. The next tune is just the answer to the dance lesson set we just had with you, who the name I will never be forgotten before. Yeah, whatever. you just heard how many non-Charleston tunes were there to be danced on. But this one is the real one, isn't it? Yeah, it's called Charleston is the Best Dance After All. And this one was one of first arrangements by the young 19-year-old Benny Carter.
Okay. One, two, three, four.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Next one is the hot tempered blues with a lot of high clarinet playing. All these numbers were written by Charlie Johnson. 'Lovely banjo solo by Spats, lovely trombone solo, lovely trumpet solos by anybody. It's wonderful. Thank you very much. Now the next tune is claimed to be written by Charlie Johnson, but of course there's a notorious guy always saying, he composed it before, you know? That was Jelly Roll Morton. And we really can't tell. We can't. Can you?
No,
we can't. Well, anyway, this was recorded 1927 by Charlie Johnson's band in Harlem, and the version by Jelly Roll Morton was recorded in
39.
Much later. So we can't believe him. We think this is the composition of Charlie Johnson, and it's called Don't You Leave Me Here, and we welcome back our wonderful Nicolle.
One, two, three, four.
this band did not only record and play very hot numbers like these two, but also kind of mood numbers, which were fashion in the day. This one, the next one, is one of those. It's called Hot Bones and Rice, but it's only hot bones, not hot music. Next one is another arrangement by Benny Carter with all his tricks for the poor reed instruments. This time he had a very tricky clarinet trio written into his arrangement of the next tune. This one is called You Ain't the One. And why are you ain't the one? That you will hear by Nicolle.
Thank you. just about done. I don't mean to cast any reflection. You don't know what a good gal means when she's talking back. I know of 100 things, sweet papa, that your loving lacks. You ain't no trouble. You ought to know that I possess a lovable nature. The things I possess are hard to find in any young creature. Before you and I could agree, there's a multitude of things to prove to me. Don't misconstrue when I say you ain't the one.
And thanks a lot to Keith, who is up there in heaven and left this wonderful arrangement to be played. Do you hear me, Keith?
No, I can't understand.
No, well, okay. Sleep well. Good night.
The boy in the boat. Another jungle style. That was popular, 1928. The boy in the boat.
Thank you.
Tom Kaiser at the growl trumpet, jungle style. So we carry on with another vocal number, which is a cheery tune about stumping and romping and doing the Birmingham stumping. The Birmingham Black Bottom must be another dance,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
But Charleston is the best dance.
Okay, Thank you very much. We hope you like this kind of hot music, though it's getting sometimes too hot. Like in the next number is really hot. It was written and arranged by Benny Waters. And I've got the feeling we start relatively slow, and he has got the feeling to speed it up. That's what we try to do now. Please cross your fingers. So you start.
Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Wonderful solos by everybody. Really fantastic. It's it's a dream come true to play with this kind of band. And here in Whitley Bay, like every year. Wonderful. Slow down a little bit to a tune called The Harlem Drag. Another composition, of course, by Charlie Johnson himself. And not to forget that this one is again by Keith Nichols, and we were so happy to do this project together when we recorded with Benny Waters. One side was Charlie Johnson, so for this event today, for 1 hour, we had not enough for to fill two sides of an LP, so this was called Memories of the 20s, and we knew Benny Waters was a well sought after, wonderful reed player and arranger already in 1928. So he recorded a lot of sides with Clarence Williams Orchestra and other guys. And so this Harlem Drag might be out of his pen, you know, because they had pens, no computers there.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
Thank you, Andy, for a wonderful solo. Lovely. And all the others for another wonderful solos. The last one for today, yeah, we're just in time, is an arrangement of a disc that was called Lost, never published, rejected by the company, but someday in the, when was it? In 2012, no, just 11 years ago, one found the test pressing, or better, the master of it, and this turned out to be one wonderful recording of Charlie Johnson's band from, and we know the recording date, it was in 1929, and so this is maybe one of the last ones. And we're happy that we could hear it. It features, of course, Jabbo Smith, and it features all other wonderful musicians in this band as well as then. And this one was originally a piano solo by
Lucky Roberts.
Lucky Roberts. You know, in this band, you know, everybody knows everything except me. So we finished this one. I was asked when this appeared on the screen, this found record, I was asked to do a transcription, and all the world took my arrangement, my transcription, and played it from New Orleans to Sweden. So this is Molasses. And we thank you very much for this wonderful hour with Charlie Johnson. Thank you.